presentation of Wind of Change. Oluwa today actualized my name. I'm the senior pastor of World Shakers International Christian Center, Abeokuta, Nigeria. Today, by the special grace of God, we shall be examining the topic that says ordained for exploits. Ordained for exploits. And our Bible passage shall be taken from John chapter 14, verse 12. John chapter 14, verse 12. Gospel according to St. John, the 14th chapter and the 12th verse. It goes thus, and I read, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than this shall he do, because I go unto my Father." Amen. Now, I want us to establish a few points as we progress in today's teaching. Number one, every believer has what it takes to do exploits for God. Every believer has what it takes to do extraordinary things for God. Every believer has what it takes to do supernatural things for God. Jesus Christ said it clearly in that John chapter 14 verse 12. He said, "He that believeth on me," he said, "the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than this shall he do, because I go unto my Father." So that means when Jesus Christ went unto the Father, he released unto every believer the ability to continue where he stopped. So every believer that follows Christ, every believer that is in Christ and whom Christ is in, has what it takes to do exploits for God. If Christ is living in you and his anointing is also living in you, Christ means the anointed one and his anointing. So if Christ is in you as a Christian, that means the anointing of the Holy One is also inside of you. That ordains you to do exploits. So every believer has what it takes to do exploits for God. Every believer has what it takes to do extraordinary things for God. And we can see it in 1 John chapter 3 verse 8. He said, "For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil." So our Lord Jesus Christ was a destroyer of satanic works. So every child of God too has what it takes to destroy satanic works. The Bible says in Acts 10:38, say how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Those were part of the works that Jesus did. He was going about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil. And that same Jesus said to you and me that the same works that he did, you will also do. And we can see it in that Acts 10:38, that part of what Jesus did was healing the sick and casting out demons and destroying the works of the devil. So as a child of God too, as a follower of Christ Jesus, you have what it takes to set the captives free. You have what it takes to destroy the works of the devil. You have what it takes to set free the oppressed. And I pray that the Almighty God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. So every believer has what it takes to do exploits. Daniel 11:32b says, "They that know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploits." So I know that those three things qualify you to do exploits as a believer. Number one, you must know God. They that know their God, according to Daniel 11:32b, they shall be strong and they shall do exploits. So the knowledge of your right brings impartation of might. So the knowledge of your right in Christ imparts might to you. So when you know God, there's this strength, there's this power that is imputed to you because of that knowledge. And with that strength that you carry, you can do exploits. So you must know God. Then number two, you must believe. Jesus said, "He that believeth on me," in that John 14:12, "he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works shall you do, because he goes unto the Father." So Jesus Christ has made it clear that if you believe in him, you will do greater works. Mark 16:17 says, "And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name they will cast out demons, they will speak with new tongues. Said if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. Said they will take up serpents. Said if you lay hands on the sick, they shall recover." So we can see that if you believe, you are qualified to do exploits. If you believe, you are naturally empowered to do exploits. So when you believe in Christ and you believe in the word of God and you believe that you have something in him, you will go far. And lastly, you must also be consecrated. You must live a holy and a sanctified life. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 1 verse 9, say, "Because you have loved righteousness and hated iniquity," say, "even the Lord your God has anointed you with the oil of gladness above your fellow." So there is this power that follows purity. Outer power is a function of inner purity. So when you have this purity, there is this power that flows out of purity. I pray God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So all I've said today, I know that you know by now, that every believer is ordained to do exploits. Every believer is ordained to do the same works that Jesus did while he was here. That Jesus is in you. And whatever he did when he was here physically, the Holy Spirit can also do through you. I pray God will help us in the name of Jesus. Well, that is how far we go on today's broadcast. The next time we meet, we shall be having another wonderful time with ourselves. Till I come your way again next time, Oluwa, as we decalize my name, I'll say to you, God bless you. Keep winning.